So, just down the hall from the green room, just past the call boards, is the dressing room. Well, it's the hallway where the dressing rooms are. You'll be able to see, because it says dressing rooms on this sign, and this big sign on the door that says access to dressing rooms. Let's take a look. We have three dressing rooms, which are labeled 1, 2, and green. 1, 2, 3. And in each dressing room, you will find that there is counter space for you to do your makeup on. There are mirrors with adjustable makeup lights next to them, like this. You can tan one bit bright if you need to. There is a coat rack in the corner where you can put your costumes. Some of them have heads for wigs. This is a great space for you to get changed in, and it is kind of like your private room during the show. You can leave your stuff in here. These doors lock. They lock from the inside, and they lock every night. We lock them every night when you leave, so that you can know that your stuff is safe in here. This is a private area where you can get changed, you can get ready. You share it with up to 4 to 7 other actors, so please be respectful of your space. Just like in the green room, you want to keep the space clean. You really want to make sure if you take any dishes out of here, don't leave food open in here. It'll attract mice and ants and gross things. We don't want that. Just keep it clean. It is yours for the show, but it is not yours to live in, right? It is yours. You're sharing it. You are here as a guest, so be nice to the space, and it'll be nice to you. The actors that you're going to share this dressing room with, every dressing room, the actors are assigned to it by the stage manager, so you'll have a list on the door that tells you who's in each room. Usually we separate these rooms by gender. There's like a room for the male actors, and given the breakdown of actors in this department, usually 2 dressing rooms for the female actors, because there's usually more women than men in a show. And if there are more actors than can be accommodated easily in these, there is a 4th room we can use, which is the trap room. So this room is the other half of that trap that I was talking about on stage. I'll show you what I mean. So this is the trap room. In the ceiling of this room, you can see the plugs I was talking about, how they have, these are panels in the ceiling that can be lifted out, and these panels are the same panels that are in the floor of the stage. So if you lift this out, you are on stage. So if you had to disappear out of stage, you would come down a ladder through the trapdoor into this room, which would be really handy because you'd be right next to the dressing rooms. But not every show is going to use that effect, and so when it's not being used as a trap, yours. You do not have to let anyone into it that is not on the list of people who are sharing it. And if you are going to, if you want to come into somebody's dressing room, you always knock on the door first and you ask to be admitted. It's like your room. But take care of it. While we're talking about dressing rooms, go back into the hallway here. In this hallway, we have 2 gender-neutral bathrooms, which are the ones with the wooden signs. There is also a shower behind them in case of body makeup or like a really complicated, messy effect on somebody. If there's things on a person's body that need to be washed off, there's a shower there. It's not like, oh, I just had a... There's not enough showers for everybody to take a shower after the show, and that would be kind of weird. But there's a shower there in case you have body makeup on or you have something from a scene on your body that needs to be washed off. That door at the end, this one here, is marked stage left, and sure enough, it opens onto a staircase that leads up to the stage left wings. This staircase leads to the stage left wings. If you go up here, you end up on
stage. At the other end of this hallway, where we came in, is the last thing I'm going to show you. So we have washrooms, the shower, and the Malkovich room. So after this, we're going to go to... The Malkovich room is named for actor John Malkovich. And it is called this because of the movie being John Malkovich, which there is a whole floor of a building that is only half height. And in this room is where we store all of the chairs. All of the chairs, all of the benches, all of the luggage. Small set props that we need live in here. This is underneath the lower audience. So the stage is kind of here, and the audience is kind of there. That door in the far corner, there are two ways into this room. One of them is through this dressing room hallway, and there's that hatch that leads to the box office. We almost never use that door. Mostly we'll come in through this door we came in through, which is in there, which leads to the dressing rooms. If you ever have to come in here to get a chair, you will have been asked by somebody. And just be careful, because this is not a public room. This is not a room that people come into if they don't know where they're going. So there's a lot of exposed ductwork and lights and things you can bump your head on. There's like screws and stuff. So just watch your head when you come in here. It's almost too short for me. And if you've met me, you know that I'm not a very tall person. So if you're any taller than me, I'm 5'5", then you're probably going to want to watch your head. And even if you're shorter than me, you're going to want to watch your head. All that's to say, watch your head if you're in here, because you'll hit your head and it'll not be fun. But this is where we store all of the chairs. This is the Malkovich room, and it's in the dressing room.